Welcome to the Way to Play Performance Series. This episode, we are featuring AP, but you may know him as Adrian Peterson. AP is one of the greatest backs in the history of the National Football League, and what made him so special, and still to this day, a special player, is his stiff arm. And that's what we're gonna talk about, and we're gonna help you get it developed. Let's be clear, there's only one Adrian Peterson, but we are seeing more and more backs coming to the National Football League that are high cut meaning taller guys. Taller backs are gonna have the problem of defenders trying to submarine at their knees, so the stiff arm becomes a valuable tool in a toolbox to create space. Now, the stiff arm may or may not be for every single back, but because we're seeing so many taller backs come into the league, guys like Derrick Henry, and back in my day, a guy like an Eddie George, those type of players will definitely want this tool in a toolbox, but it's not something that's easy to utilize. It's a tool that you have to be prepared to use. But the problem is, there's so much chaos. So what we want to try to do now is just build the base stability for the stiff arm, and then we'll get dynamic later. So let's just look at the base posture. We're going to have Brian here. Come on over. And we're going to take a physio ball. If you don't have a physio ball, we're going to come back with a basketball as a demo. And we're gonna pin it against the wall. And we're gonna try to get Brian first just into a comfortable position before we really start to challenge him. And then you also see here, he has the good old football, the pigskin in that right arm, pretending to be a ball carrier. You're very similar to Adrian Peterson, B. So here we go. What B's gonna do here is stabilize at the shoulder. We're gonna challenge him at the core, and we're also gonna challenge them at the hips. These are the key areas with a stiff arm. If you aren't strong in the core, when you go to jam that arm, you're gonna get twisted. If you aren't strong in the and stable in the hips, you go to jam that arm, you're gonna get spun around. And the same thing with the shoulder. You have to make sure that you're strong and stable at the shoulder as you're applying that force through the defender. So you ready, B? We're gonna challenge this posture. We're gonna go here, same arm, same leg. Come on, hold it up. Same arm, same leg first, stay there. And we're gonna just hold it. Hold it for a five count. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Bring it on down. Let's switch the ball, switch the ball. Here we go. We're gonna do it again, same arm, same leg. Here we go, hold it. There you go. What's happening now is he's challenging the stiff arm posture. And when you get really good at it, you get your coach to come and try to break the ball out of it, because that's what's gonna happen when you're on a football field. Now we got one more position. Same arm, opposite leg. Because with the stiff arm, as we said, there's so much chaos, you don't know when and how you're gonna have to throw it. It might be here, it might be when you're, I don't know, I'm not a running back, so I don't know how this is supposed to look, but I just know that this right here is very difficult to do. So now we got opposite arm, opposite leg, and again, we're gonna hold this for about 5 seconds. As you get better at it, you can have someone begin to just try to break the posture. Good job, B. If you don't have a physio ball, good old basketball would be enough. The difference between the basketball and the basketball, it will be a little bit easier, but again, we're not trying to create world beaters today. We're just trying to get you a little bit better each and every day. So again, the key with the stiff arm, build stability first, stability in that posture. Now what we're gonna do is take you through the dynamic portion of the posture, because it's a chaotic world. The stiff arm is a challenging movement, and if you can master it, you got a better chance of becoming the best player you can be.
When we look at the stiff arm, we have to take into account all the different type of pressures we're gonna be taking. We don't know where the defender's coming from, we're running, maybe we're stiff arming one athlete and another athlete's hitting us. There's just a lot of chaos and a lot of unpredictability. So you really can't prepare for it just in the weight room alone with your traditional lifts. One thing we love is this lateral hip lock. All you need is a wall, you could do this anywhere, great way to start your day. What we want you to do, think of, is put your forearm into this wall and drive it in as hard as you can. I want you to start with both feet on the ground, but you're slightly at an angle. You're leaning towards that wall and drive as hard as you can, in this case with your right leg. And when you drive, I want you to be coming upright. So you're pushing into that wall still, we're keeping pressure. If there was something there, we couldn't remove it. If it was a blanket or a towel between them, I couldn't pull it out because he's putting that much pressure on the wall. He's sinking and knocking it over. Now, if you notice, he's putting force to the ground. On the first one, I want you to come up on your toe. We hold these for 5 seconds and literally drive as hard as you can and then relax. And the next one, just to switch it up, we're gonna go whole foot, so more instep. Drive as hard as you can. You'll feel slightly different. You'll feel the first one at the toe, a little bit of your low leg and that side and upper glute. And this flat-footed one, you'll feel more of that side, upper glute, and a little bit of your adductor. So mix them up both in, hold them for 5 seconds as hard as you can, and just kind of progress from there.
If you notice one thing about Adrian Peterson's stiff arms, each one is unique and unlike the others, because when we're on the field and throwing a stiff arm, you can't plan out exactly what step you're gonna throw your hand. You aren't gonna plan out where the defender is going to be. So our shoulders need to be mobile and strong through a bunch of different angles. One movement that you can use to get your shoulders strong is the 3D press. Now it's a variation of the overhead press, but instead of pressing just straight up in a controlled fashion, we're gonna get outside the frame of the body, similar to how we would if we were throwing a stiff arm. So we have four different angles that we're gonna press from. The first one is going to be across the body. So Brian's gonna press and he's gonna rotate his whole body to try to reach the dumbbell as far out as he can. We're gonna do the same going forward, where he's pressing forward, rotating at the shoulders to get the dumbbell as far out. We'll go out to the side, and then the last one will go out and back. So now we have to rotate and open ourselves up. Now, one thing that's really nice about this exercise is not just a shoulder movement. If you notice, Brian is rotating at his core. He's having to rotate at the hips, and that's very similar to how we're going to be pressing on the field. Now, if you want to add one variation to this, we can do it out of a staggered stance. So Brian can put one foot forward, and now it's putting a lot more challenge on this front hip when he presses across and as he presses out. And then when he goes out to the side, it's really challenging that back hip a lot too, and we can make it even harder with that rotate out. And then again, you wanna make sure you're doing both stances because you never know what foot you're gonna be on when you're throwing a stiff arm. We'll go through all of these right here. And last one, good. So don't think of this movement as a shoulder exercise because we're not isolating the shoulder. We want the whole body moving at the same time, much similar to how we are gonna throw a stiff arm on the field.
A great movement in the weight room that can help you really take your strength and all the skill that you're building in that weight room and apply it to the field is the simple dumbbell box step up and overhead press. So all we have here is we have our demonstrator here. He has the dumbbell in his left arm, right? He has the elbow kind of pulled in tight. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna step on the box with our opposite leg. So we're going opposite arm, opposite leg to begin with. And as you can see, he has to extend that hip to find stability, all right? And this hip's kind of in flexion. This is the movement that you're seeing on the field when we're going into that stiff arm. Now, next what he's gonna do is he's gonna go same arm, same leg. Because sometimes when we're in that stiff arm, right? We don't have the luxury of being opposite arm, opposite leg. We kind of just have to throw it when it comes. And we're building some of that single leg strength, right? The glutes having to help to stabilize us. And also, we're getting some stability in this overhead press. You're probably asking, come on, you can go on down. And you're probably asking, why are we going overhead to begin with? Well, we're talking shoulder stability, okay? If we can get overhead into this extended position, this is kind of going to help you to be able to put your shoulder in different angles, be it in front of you or side of you. If you can't get overhead, more likely you're going to have trouble with the other angles that you're being forced to kind of put that shoulder in on the field. So we're trying to get some strength, get some stability in the shoulder joint here. Now, that's kind of our general prescription for the dumbbell box step up and press. Now what we're going to do is we're going to go more specific. And what the band is gonna do is gonna add that specific anti-rotational core benefit that we need, because when we hit contact on the stiff arm, right, it kind of wants us to open up, right? Because we're fighting pressure. It wants to open us up, so we need some anti-rotational core strength. Also, right, let's now put that shoulder in that specific joint angle that we're gonna see on the field. So we're gonna see one where we're pressing horizontally and then one we're kind of pressing in front. Ready? So now he's gonna, as you can see, he has this kind of hand underhand. It's like he's holding a football. And as he presses, he's gonna press on a horizontal angle with the opposite leg. Good, so as you can see, same footwork as the first general one, but we're getting more specific up top. We got the shoulder where we're building that stability, and this band is trying to open them up. So that's where we're getting that anti-rotational benefit. Now he's coming forward, same thing, the band's trying to open them up, but we're putting that force to the ground on the box, right? We're extending that hip to find that stability that we need, and that's kind of what's gonna happen on the field when dealing with that stiff arm and performance. So make sure you do this dumbbell box step up and press. It's definitely gonna help you.
Now there you have it. The team took you through how to develop a stiff arm similar to Adrian Peterson. So now that you're away from the game, and even if you're in the game today, get to working on it. It's a valuable tool to have in the toolbox.